Hi, it's me Sabida and you're watching Aksharapura. Today I'll tell you the story of A Letter to God. This is a very interesting story. It tells the story of a man who is a believer of God. There is nothing which can kill his belief, actually. We can say in that way, because there is something which is in his mind which tells him that he has that strong belief, strong bond with God. So let's listen to this story. And before you start listening to the story, if you are watching my video for the first time, please do subscribe my channel and like and share. And if you like or if you don't like also, please comment on the video. So let's begin the story. There is a man who was living in a village, and this story is happening in Latin America. The name of the man is Lencho. He was a farmer, a poor old farmer he was. He and his family was living in a hilly area, and when the story starts itself, we can see that there is a hill and there is only one house which is visible at that area. And that's the house of this Lencho and his family. He is a farmer, basically he is a farmer, and nearby his house only, his farm is there. He has a corn farm. Okay, so he and his family are having a very happy time because it's almost time for the rainy season and they are awaiting for the rain. So this information we come to know from the from a conversation that Lencho and his family had when they were having their dinner. So they are all hoping for the rain to approach so that they will be having gold coins from their cornfield. Okay, and they are all awaiting for the rain. So time passed. In the next 2 days, instead of rain, something else came, and that was another than snow. So it started hailstorm. There was a snowfall and it was total devastation for the life of and the crops of Lencho. All his crops got rotten. All his crops got spoiled. So they, instead of getting gold coins which they expected to get from the corn field, they got nothing else other than the rotten corn crops. So usually every farmer is dependent upon the climate, weather. Everything is actually bringing about or killing or upbringing a farmer. But here Lencho was not ready to be sad. He told his family, "There is no need to worry because our God is there." And the next day, he started to the post office. He went to the post office, took a paper, wrote a letter. And the letter was addressed to God. So he wrote the letter, and with so much confidence, on the top he wrote the address also. And that was to God. Only that much was written, to God. And it was posted. When the postman was sealing the letters, he saw this weird address actually. According to him, it was weird. So he thought, "Oh, what is this? A man or a person has written a letter to God and nothing else is there, no address, nothing else is there." So he got excited actually. He got eager to know what might be written in this letter. So he took this letter to the postmaster. So the postmaster was also eager to know what is written inside. Even though it's not mean to open someone else's letter, but they opened the letter and they read the letter. So what was written in that letter was, Lencho is writing the letter and saying that, "God, I lost my crop this time. So I need 100 pesos for me to sustain this time, this year. So I request you to give me 100 pesos. This was the letter written by Lencho to the God. At first, the postman and the postmaster made fun of this man who wrote a letter to God asking for some money. But later on, the postmaster got moved with this letter and he said, no, we should write a reply to him under the disguise of God. It's not really writing a letter. We'll try to collect the money and post him the same amount which he's asking for. So he took some amount from his own salary and also he collected some amount from the willing people who are ready to contribute from his his colleagues only. He took some amount and he could collect some amount, and that was 70 pesos. So the postmaster was too happy to see that, okay, I could collect 70 pesos for the man. And he did this actually because he didn't want to dismay the man. He didn't want to. Anyway, he understood that Lenjo was a faithful, so faithful person. So he didn't want to destroy that faith Lenjo had in God. And anyway, he wrote a reply letter to Lenjo stating that, okay, this is the money from God. Only this much was written and the money was enclosed in the envelope. So the next day, with so much confidence, Lenjo came for the letter. So he asked for the letter and the postman, with so much excitement, he gave the letter to Lenjo. He gave the letter. So Lenjo opened the letter and the postman was awaiting to see what he might be doing, or whether he will be happy, how much happiness the man will be. So both the postman and the postmaster, all the people were excited to know what he might be doing just after opening the letter. When Lenjo opened the letter, he was so angry. He was not satisfied. He felt so unhappy. So he wrote a letter again. So the letter was like, God, I have asked for 100 pesos and I know that you might have given 100 pesos, but these postal people are crooked men. They have looted my money. They have taken 30 pesos which you have given me. So please, God, give the remaining amount to me, that's the 30 pesos, but don't give that amount through these crooked people. That was the second letter written by Lenjo. And he posted the letter as usual. He posted the letter with so much confidence. And the postman, again, just after Lenjo left the room, the postman went and opened the letter and read the letter which is written to God again. The second letter which is written by Lenjo to God. And in that letter, they came to know that Lenjo is still having full faith in God. There is nothing which can destroy his faith. His faith cannot be defeated. So the postmaster understood that this is a person who feels that God is there to help him at any difficult situation. And just like anyone talking with a friend, this man, this uneducated, we can say, because he is little bit literate only, he can just read and write, he is not very educated, but still he had strong belief in God, whom he has never seen. Actually, he might not have seen, or we can say that we are not seeing God, but still God is there. The presence of God can be felt by everyone, anyone. Only thing is that we need to listen to that call. We need to listen to that voice. Then everyone can hear that voice which God will be giving us. That's the information that is connected to us from anywhere and nowhere towards the human soul or any living soul. So this is the story of Lenjo, a poor farmer who had strong belief in God, and this belief which cannot be destroyed by any circumstance, any difficult situation even. So he believed that even though some difficult situations I am going through, still God will be there to help me out from this situation. So this is how the story ends, with the second letter. So in this story there are two letters, and both the letters are written to God himself. So this is the story about a letter to God, and the main character is Lencho, and the postman and the postmaster are the supporting characters who actually helped Lencho to continue with his belief throughout his life. Okay, bye, thank you.